I've already been using my unfinished bandsaw to cut out the trunnions to make a tilting table that goes right here. And the trunnions on the bandsaw allow the table to tilt in such a way that the axis of tilt is actually at the top of the table. Without trunnions, like on the scroll saw where it's just hinged right here, the table moves side to side quite a lot with respect to the blade when it's tilted. And the other thing that's nice about trunnions is I can just tighten them down like this, and that locks the angle of the table. And here's the first of my trunnions with the paper template still attached. And the way I made these trunnions, I cut my templates out slightly oversized and then traced those around on some Baltic birch plywood, rough cut those out of a big sheet of plywood, and then cut according to the bigger outline on my bandsaw to get the approximate shapes. Now the top part needs to have a slot in it like this to swivel around the bolt. And I made that by making hardwood spacers to go in between, and these are also cut from templates on the bandsaw. And then I glued those spacers onto one half of it, and then glued the other half on just so I didn't have to line up too many things at once. And after that, I cut the final lines using my templates on the bandsaw. And then taking off the final little bit on my belt sander to get it exactly to the templates. Now the other part of the trunnion only has a hole in the middle layer, and I figured it was easiest to drill that hole in there after I glued all three layers together. And this is the third time I'm building a bandsaw with trunnions, and every time I'm amazed not only that they work, but how well they work. Because even though this is my fifth bandsaw build, my first bandsaw didn't have a tilting table. My bandsaw number two, that's this one there, was the first to use trunnions. Then for bandsaw number three, I figured I'd try to simplify it and switch to hinges instead. But then for bandsaw number four, I decided that the hinges really weren't a good idea. So I put trunnions on it, and then this bandsaw number five, the trunnions on that one are very similar to the ones on bandsaw four. Now this whole arrangement needs to be supported from the back by a beam that attaches here, but much bigger, this one actually, like this. To accurately position this part on here, I'm just going to use a complementing template to position the dowel holes in both parts, and then the dowels will line things up. I'm just going to put in a few dowels for this dry fit, but even so, it'll be pretty hard to get apart again. Before I pulled the template off, I scored some lines through it, and you can see that here and here, and here, 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 and here. So I'm pretty close. Now I just gotta cut a big notch for it to fit over the lower wheel. And another notch to make room for the blade guides. I'm just working out how and where to mount the trunnions. So to position it, I traced back the line of the blade right here, and then I have to move over by 22 millimeters. And that also happens to be the distance from here to this position here. It's 22 millimeters to the edge. And for the forward position, I needed to stick out by the right amount here. And I cut this notch to line up with the front of the frame here. So if you cut it to the dimensions in the plans, just go by that notch right there. Now to attach it, I want to use some quarter inch long wood screws or wood bolts, like the ones I used in here, but longer ones. And to position those, I have to be careful to avoid all these dowels that join the back trunnion support. So I've marked where good screw hole positions are that won't interfere with any other holes in here. Now I have to transfer the hole locations to the bandsaw frame. Now I have to work out where the blade guide mounting holes go. If this beam was made out of hardwood, I could just cut machine screw threads right into it. But as it's softwood, I have to use threaded inserts. I gotta square out these holes for the carriage bolt heads. Oops. I still have to make a nice knob to go on the bottom. Now that I'm confident in everything, I can start gluing it together. Uh-oh. This goes in the other side. Whoops. Shit. I couldn't get that joint quite closed. There's a little bit of a gap here, but that's okay. That's the rear trunnion. It's not as important as the front one. I still need to buy much bigger wood screws, so for now I'm just using those. And the advantage of that is I don't wear out the holes in the wood prematurely. Trunnions are done. Now comes the table. And I should have just used two layers of Baltic birch, but instead I used cheap plywood, made my own veneer, trim around the edges, still gotta do work to that, still gotta mount it. So that will be a video all on its own.